Good afternoon, viewers. Today we are bringing you a live broadcast of Mr. Weibo. I'm Trevin Popwell.
And I'm Matt Mitchell. Trevin, this is my first year experiencing Mr. Weibo. Could you help me fill in on what we're going to be seeing today?
Well, Matt, Mr. Weibo is a contest for the junior and senior boys here at Western Boone. The boys will go through a series of events such as a swimsuit competition, talent competition, and a Q&A.
Sounds like it's going to be a lot of fun and an eventful night, Trevin.
Hopefully it will be, Matt. Let's take a look at our contestants for tonight's event. Our first contestant is Reese Thompson. Reese is a senior here at Western Boone. He is involved in soccer and track here at Weibo.
Our next contestant is Barton Martin. He is a junior here at Weibo. Mr. Martin is also a track runner here at Western Boone High School.
Our third contestant is Zach Neff. He was a part of the conference-winning tennis team this year.
Our fourth contestant today is Duncan Reed. He is another senior here at Weibo and is involved in soccer, basketball, and baseball.
Today's fifth contestant is Adam Meadows. He is a junior and he will be wrestling for his first time this year here at Weibo.
The sixth contestant is Michael Dunn. He is a senior here at Weibo. He was a part of the soccer team and he will be continuing his athletics going into track this season.
Our seventh contestant is Devin Vickery. He is a junior and plays a trumpet in the Western Boone Band.
Our next contestant today is Zach Anderson. He is also a senior here. Today, Zach is a part of the Western Boone football team this year.
Our ninth contestant is Patrick Schallenberger. He is a junior here at Weibo. He plays football, basketball, and hopefully will be playing a spring sport later in the year.
Our tenth contestant is Dalton Brown. He is a senior here. He plays football and runs track for Weibo.
Our next contestant is John Clutter. He is another senior for this competition. He was a part of the soccer team and will run track later this year.
Our next contestant is Dalton Davis. He is also a senior at Weibo. He is a part of the FFA community around here.
Our last contestant is Felix Martinez. He is the last senior part of Mr. Weibo. He competed in this competition last year and won Mr. Congeniality. He is part of the band and will hope to win this year.
And here we'll be throwing it to the interview with our live contestants.
Guys, I'm sitting here with Reese Thompson. Reese, I noticed you don't have a shirt. Can you tell me a little bit why you don't have a shirt?
Well, for the swimsuit competition, you know, can't wear a shirt because you got to look good. And I actually have angel wings painted on my back that are still wet with paint, so I have to let those dry.
Oh, yeah, be sure not to get that on the back of the chair. What have you enjoyed most about Mr. Weibo?
Well, it's not about the competition. It's really about the guys just taking a group of good guys together and just letting them dance. Like, that's pretty crazy, chaotic, and seeing all the different talents that Weibo contestants have to offer.
That's great. I mean, this is your first year doing it, right?
This or is my second year.
Oh, it's your second year. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it's your second year doing it. Do you still have nerves about what you're doing on stage?
I do magic, so there's always a possibility that I could mess up, and that makes me a little nervous, but in the end, it's worth it.
Okay, well, tell me a little bit about your magic. Like, what made you get into magic?
Well, I'm into magic. I'm a big fan of Penn and Teller, two famous magicians. I watch them a lot in study hall, so I really like watching their magic videos and seeing how it's done.
All right, thanks, Reese. I think we'll move on to our second contestant, Bart Martin.
Thank you.
We're going to send it back to the news desk right now.
Thanks, Colin. That was a great interview. Our next contestant will be Barton Martin, and hopefully he'll be ready here in a few minutes, and we'll get right back to him. But, Trevin, you guys had a football game last night. How'd that go?
Well, it went pretty well. We beat the number one team state and number one football team in the state, 21-14.
All right, we'll get back with that, but we're going to throw it right back to the interview with Barton Martin.
All right, like you said, we're back here with Barton Martin. Bart, what made you want to do Mr. Weibo?
I just thought it sounded kind of fun. You know, just why not try and win?
So is this your first year doing Mr. Weibo?
It is.
Can you tell us what your talent, like some of your talents and what they were going to be?
My talent is I tell dad jokes.
Oh, really?
Can you elaborate on that a little bit? Like, what are dad jokes to the audience?
Okay. Dad jokes are pretty much like really bad jokes or puns that are clever, but, you know, most people, you know, it's, the most you get out of it is like, ha, that's pretty good.
Do you think you could tell us one?
You're just going to have to wait.
Ooh, okay, I like the suspense. All right, we're going to send it back to the news desk with Matt and Trevin again, and we're going to have our next contestant come up, Zach Neff.
Thanks, Colin. Our next contestant is Zach Neff, as he said, and Trevin, you know, you go here to Weibo. Who do you think is going to have a good chance of winning tonight?
Well, I think Felix Martinez has a pretty good chance. As I said before, he was Mr. Congeniality, and this year he made his own instrument to play for his talent.
He made his own instrument. Well, let's go ahead and look at a live interview with him right now.
Thanks, guys. We're sitting here with Zach Neff. And Zach, what are some of your special talents?
My talent for Mr. Weibo is going to be a video of me painting.
Video of you painting, okay. What made you get into painting?
I watch Bob Ross videos sometimes, and it just seems really cool, and I thought maybe I should try it out.
What kind of things are you going to paint?
Today I painted a mountainscape.
Oh, that's nice.
So when you say a video, does that mean you're not really going to be on stage at all? Is it just going to show a video of you?
I will be on stage standing beside the video, but all of it is pre-recorded.
Okay. Why do you feel like you're the best pick for Mr. Weibo?
I feel like Mr. Weibo is a good fit for me because I just kind of want to put myself out there more, and I think this is a good experience to do so.
All right. Well, that's great. Zach, thank you for your time. We're going to send it back to the news desk yet again with Matt and Trevin. Our next contestant coming up will be Duncan Reed.
Thanks, Colin, yet again. And that was Zach Neff. Sorry about the confusion. And Trevin, you must know Duncan Reed. What do you got to say about him?
Oh, he's a pretty good kid, well-rounded, very athletic, some people say. And hopefully he has a pretty good shot of winning Mr. Weibo again this year, too.
All right, let's go ahead and throw it right back into that interview.
Thanks, guys. Sitting here with Duncan Reed. Duncan, why do you feel like you're the best pick for Mr. Weibo?
Oh, man, to say I deserve any more than any of these other guys, that's a stretch, but I'm mainly just out here to have a good time, have fun, get out here with some new guys that maybe I didn't spend some time with before, and find some sides to me that I didn't know existed. And I also like to share some love for Trevin. I love you, buddy.
That's great. Are there any nerves that you feel?
I'd honestly have to say I'm a little bit more nervous for the swimsuit portion than I am probably for even the talent or any other portion, mostly because when you're out there in your skibbies, so much can go wrong.
So, Trevin said you have a lot of athletic ability. Are you going to be showing any of that today?
Yeah, I will. I'm doing 8-foot trick dunks. as much as I would love to say I could dunk a 10-foot basketball goal, I can't 100% of the time. So, we're going to knock it down 2 feet and see if I can get one down that way.
Nice.
Hopefully that confidence keeps kicking in. We're going to go back to the news desk with Trevin and Matt.
Thanks, boys.
Duncan. Our next contestant will be Adam Meadows. Trevin, you got anything to say about Mr. Meadows?
Oh, well, he's a pretty talented singer, and he's also a pretty good band member, so we'll see that pretty soon.
All right, let's go ahead and throw it to him.
Okay, guys, we have a little bit of time left here for another interview. We got Adam Meadows sitting here with us. Adam, what made you want to do Mr. Weibo?
I would say just trying to get a new experience.
What kind of experience are you talking about?
Usually I'm kind of like an introvert, so I'm trying to get out there, you know, learn some new things.
So that's good.
So what's your talent this evening?
My talent would be playing my bass guitar.
Oh, so what got you interested in playing guitar?
I've always been into music heavily ever since I was little, and just seeing people like Cliff Burton just sit up there and shred on the bass guitar, saying that not only can guitars do it, but bass can do it, just made me want to do it. So
that's great. We've got a few more contestants coming up. We're going back to Matt and Trevin, and then we're going to bring up our next interviewee.
Colin, our next contestant is Mr. Michael Dunn. You know Michael at all, Trevin?
I do know him pretty well. He was a captain of the soccer team, and he won state in a 4x4 indoor track team this year. So we'll bring it back to him.
Thanks, guys. Sitting here with Michael Dunn. Michael, what are some of your special talents?
Well, this year I'll be reenacting famous movie scenes from the 1980s.
What kind of movie scenes?
Raiders of the Lost Ark, Karate Kid, Top Gun, Ferris Bueller's Day Off, and Risky Business.
Oh, that's pretty good. Got some actors in the house tonight. All right, we're going to go back to Matt and Trevin real quick. We're going to bring up our next contestant, which is Devin Vickery.
Thanks, Colin. It was a good interview. Our next contestant will be Devin Vickery. And Trevin, do you have anything to say about Mr. Vickery?
He's a great kid, and he has a pretty good shot winning this also as a junior.
All right, let's go ahead and toss it to them.
Thanks, Trevin and Matt. We're here with Devin Vickery. And Devin, can you tell us a little bit about your talents this evening?
This afternoon, I'm going to be playing the trumpet. The Mario theme.
Oh, what inspired you to do the Mario theme?
During homecoming week, me and Felix Martinez dressed up as Mario, and I just felt to play the Mario theme.
Okay. Thanks, Devin. That's all for this interview. Now we'll send it back to Trevin and Matt and bring up our next interviewee.
Our next contestant here is Zach Anderson. So can you tell me a little bit about him?
He's a smart kid. I'm hoping to see a lot from him today. Hopefully he has a good chance of winning it. Let's go ahead and throw it to them.
Zach, I talked to you a little bit before the show about playing your guitar. What got you into playing guitar?
Well, I've always been growing up around music. My sister started taking piano lessons when I was about 4, and I quickly soon started when I was 6. And a couple years later when I was 9, I got my first guitar, and it just went from there.
That's nice. What kind of music will you be playing?
Today I'm playing 5,000 Candles in the Wind from Parks and Recreation.
Huh. Interesting song choice. Back to Matt and Trevin now at the news desk for our next interviewee.
Patrick Schallinger. Trevin, you know anything about Schallenberger?
Schallenberger at first. And he's a junior here, and he likes to play football and likes to lift a lot. So hopefully his swimsuit part will be pretty well.
All right, let's go ahead and toss it to them.
Thanks, guys. Sitting here with Patrick. Patrick, you had a pretty good night the other night. But what can you bring to this show right here other than, you know, football ability?
Bringing to the show, Colin, I would say would just be to have fun. I mean, everybody over here, they're in it to win it. I'm just here to have fun and for the ride.
Can you tell us what your talent's going
to
be?
My talent is I am going to sing a little Josh Turner, Long Black Train, and play it on the guitar.
Got some country going on up in here. All right, we're going back to the news desk with Matt and Trevin.
Thanks, Colin. Our next contestant will be Dalton Brown. Trevin, you know anything about Mr. Brown?
Oh, I know a lot about Mr. Dalton Brown. He was also part of the track team at that one state in the indoor track meet, and hopefully that he does really well in his competition.
All right, let's toss it to Jake, right back with it.
Thanks, Matt. I'm here with Dalton Brown. Dalton, can you tell us what your talent is going to be this evening?
I will be playing Careless Whisper by Wham on the alto saxophone.
What inspired you to choose that song?
You know, I've always kind of listened to it. It's a nice jazz song, saxophone, and always got to show love for the saxophone, so decided to play it.
All right. Thanks, Dalton. Now we'll send it back to Matt and Trevin at the news desk.
Our next contestant is John Clutter. Trevin, you know anything about Mr. Clutter?
Mr. Clutter, he is part of the soccer team this year. He is a captain, and he will be running track later, and hopefully they'll win conference this year.
All right, let's go back to Colin.
Thanks, guys. John, you're also called Miles, but how far can you go in this competition?
I think I can win it. That's just my personal opinion.
What makes you think you can win it?
I don't see any reason I wouldn't.
I like your confidence, Miles.
Strong words, strong confidence. Back to the news desk now.
Our next contestant is Dalton Davis. Mr. Davis plays golf. You have anything else about him?
Well, he's a great FFA member. He's got some nice pigs to show around here, and his dad is also part of the school board, so there may be some favors around here.
Ooh, some controversy. Let's go over to the interview.
Thanks, guys. Sitting here with Dalton Davis. Dalton, got your country hat on, got your belt buckle.
Yep.
I see. What can you bring to this competition?
Well, the nice thing about my talent is it interacts with the crowd quite a bit, and not other talents do that. And I think I bring a sort of funny, serious personality to the table that I think is hard to beat.
Why do you think you can win Mr. Weibo?
I'm funny. My talent's pretty dang good, and I think my dancing skills are outmatched out there on the stage. So,
Got some happy feet out there. Back to the news desk.
Great interview with Mr. Davis. Our last contestant will be Felix Martinez. Trevin, you have anything to say about Mr. Martinez?
Oh, he is a well-rounded kid. He got second last year at Mr. Congeniality, and this year he hopes to bring it home this year.
All right, let's go ahead and toss it in with that interview.
So, Felix, I understand that you won Mr. Congeniality next year. Do you think there's any major person standing in your way this year from winning Mr. Weibo?
Oh, I'd say it's Zach Anderson. He's playing 5,000 Candles in the Wind. That is a really great performance right there.
So what is your talent going to be this evening?
I'm playing Under the Sea. It's a great American classic on the tubulum, which is a marimba made out of pipes.
Thanks, Felix. Now we'll send it back to the news desk.
Thanks, guys. We're getting ready to start the show here shortly around 2 o'clock. As for now, we're just going to have some fun and get ready for the show. So, Trevin, how was the game last Friday?
Okay. The game, well, it was great. We had some ups and downs, and when we got there, it was around 35 degrees with freezing rain, and we thought it would be very chilly. Later towards the game, before the started, we got on the field to see how slippery it was, see hopefully that we can run the routes right, and hopefully it wouldn't fall on the field. It started to warm up towards later, like before the middle of the game, at around 50 degrees when we started. During the game, they hit us in the mouth first, they scored a touchdown, and we just couldn't answer. And then in the second quarter, around 5 minutes left, we finally scored a touchdown, and we tied the game up, and our defense, they were driving on us, and they ended it on the 1 yard line, and the quarter ended. So we tied at halftime at 7-7.
All right, let's go ahead and take a look in at our show as we get started for the day. So, Trevin, do you have any other good luck gifts for the rest of the contestants tonight?
Well, hopefully they all just perform the best they can, because at the end of the day, it's also all about having fun, and hopefully the seniors just make sure they have a good time, and the juniors, hopefully they'll compete next year, they can just learn about what they did and what they didn't do right, and hopefully they can bring that into next year so that they can win.
Sounds like fun. Other than Mr. Felix Martinez, do you have any other guesses who might have a chance to come and sneaking around and getting this victory?
I really do think Zach Anderson has a great shot, because most people know what 5,000 Candles in the Wind is all about and Parks and Rec. Very great show, and he has a beautiful voice, by the way.
Well, I'm telling you, I'm excited about seeing Mr. Davis.
Ladies and gentlefolks, good afternoon. We would like to welcome you to the 2017 production of Mr. Weebo. I'm Lucy Evans.
And I'm Lizzie Hendricks, and we're really glad you decided to spend your Sunday with us. We are very excited to introduce our crazy contestants and hardworking staff.
But we have to set some ground rules. First, we encourage photography and videography of the show for any social media of your choice. However, we strongly discourage distractions, so please turn off all sound on all of your devices and please refrain from using flash photography.
Secondly, our Mr. Weebo team understands it can be difficult to quiet down a child when restless. But we do ask that if your child does become restless, that you escort yourselves out of the theater and return in an appropriate manner.
Please feel free to laugh, to cry, to hoot, and to holler for your favorite contestant, but in an appropriate manner and time. So sit back, relax,
and don't have any popcorn, because food and drinks are prohibited in the auditorium.
But enjoy the show. About some of our contestants. Michael Dunn, a senior here at Western Boone, loves puppies and long walks on the beach. Duncan Reed doesn't actually own the boots he's wearing. Zach Neff has caught a 22-pound catfish before. Boys, we also have lots of interesting stuff about our staff members. Riley Ramsey is left-handed. She's working backstage today. Becky Collins was born in Brazil. And Emily Boyles has a lucky bucket. I don't really know what that means. Okay, let's see, what else do we have? Patrick Schellenberger has been singing Josh Turner in the Shower since he was 3 years old. Lindsay Kaufman, another one of our staff members, has two different colored eyelashes. Apparently. Elena Dickey enjoys spending most of her time in the art room. Martin's name rhymes. Our vice editor, Lindsay Hendricks, wasn't really planning on living this long, but because she is, she plans to study special education at Ball State. Shelby Dorwart, another one of our staff members, is a first-year senior on staff, and during her first year of showing horses, she won English showmanship. I am looking
looking to continue my education in a college somewhere to study children's ministry. Woo! This is all I have. Our boys are in such straight lines. It's impressive. Do you have a joke besides your giant dreams? No. I do. Would you like to hear a joke? Okay. What is a pirate's favorite fruit punch?
I don't know.
Hi, C! What does a nosy pepper do? Gets jalapeno business! What kind of pasta is always scared? What? Chicken Alfredo! What? Oh! What's a fish with no eyes? Psh! Psh! Let's see. I wish I had more facts about that. This has ran smoothly every time we've practiced.
It's all right.
That's kind of how things work, though.
I don't know.
Okay. We'd like to give a big shout out to Mr. Foxworthy and his radio and TV team. They work really hard throughout the week to provide morning announcements, and in one of those morning announcements later in the week, they're going to have a segment for the Mr. Weibo contestants, and each boy was interviewed before the start of this show. And so hopefully that will be, I don't know, it might be on YouTube. Okay, we're going to make adjustments because that's how the world works. Here we go.
Boom, clap, boom, de clap, de clap, boom, boom, clap, boom, de clap, de clap, boom, boom, clap, boom, de clap, de clap, boom, boom, clap, boom, de clap, de clap. Try with me, here we go. Boom, boom, clap, boom, de clap.
Expect the audience to know who we're talking about.
You make a very valid point, Lizzie. You see, we understand sometimes it's hard to know who exactly is on stage when you only came to support your distant nephew by marriage. So we've decided to make it a little easier for you.
Each contestant was asked a series of questions, and these were the best, most pleasing answers that we could get. Please meet our 2017 Mr. Weibo contestants.
Hi.
And we're back.
While the screen's coming down and you were preparing to view this video, the dance we just did, if you couldn't tell, it's Hoedown Throwdown by Hannah Montana, but the dance was choreographed together by our own Becky Collins. Woo! The boys were required to attend one of two rehearsals and then do the rest of the learning the dance on their own. This is Becky Collins. She did the dance.
If you had to be a Disney princess, who would you choose?
Well, at least you know the video works. Yay for things working.
If you had to be a Disney princess, who would you choose and why?
Snow White, because she likes trolls.
What celebrity would play you in a movie about yourself?
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
If you had to be a Disney princess, who would you choose and why?
I would be Ariel, because it'd be fun to swim.
If you had to be a Disney princess, who'd you choose?
Ooh. Alright, so I'm going to say Belle on that one, because when I went to the princess breakfast, Belle gave me a kiss on the cheek, so she's my favorite.
If you had to be a food, what would you be and why?
I would have to say probably a steak, because I'm very big.
What celebrity would play you in a movie about yourself?
I would say Johnny Depp, because there's no celebrity that looks like me, and Johnny Depp can make himself look like anybody. So I'd say Johnny Depp.
If you had to be a food, what would you be and why?
I'd be a sucker, because they're tasty.
What celebrity would play you in a movie about yourself?
Jonah Hill.
You are about to get into a fight. What song comes on as your soundtrack?
Well, I see myself as a lover and not a fighter, but if there's that small chance that I did get into a fight, I would think that the Kung Fu Panda fighting song would come on, because sometimes I can be kind of goofy, and if I was fighting, probably use a couple kicking moves. And do not think I would win, though, but I would attempt to try my hardest.
If you had to be a Disney princess, who would you choose and why?
I'd be Rapunzel, because I have long hair and I'm blonde.
If you had to be a food, what would you be and why?
A waffle. I don't know why.
What celebrity would play you in a movie about yourself?
A movie about myself, I'd like to see Leonardo DiCaprio play me, because I think we resemble each other very well. We're both very good looking, and I think he'd portray me very, very nicely.
If you had to be a Disney princess, who would you choose and why?
Elsa, because I actually have her costume and she's just the best princess.
Well, if that wasn't
interesting,
I don't know what would be.
We hope you loved the video put together by our wonderful freshman staff members, and that you can remember the contestants' names a bit better now.
If you haven't caught the gist,
the yearbook staff pretty much runs the world.
I don't really know about that, but at least the Mr. Weibo world. And we are so thankful that you decided to come. Our yearbook is fully funded and operated by the yearbook staff.
And Mr. Weibo is the biggest fundraiser that we do all year. The ticket money that you gave at the door goes directly to helping produce our book. The boys have politely asked that we explain exactly what the rest of the yearbook stands for in the shirts that say Be Do. And it's a very simple answer.
This year's theme for the 2017-2018 yearbook is In the Middle of Nowhere, You Can Be Anyone and Do Anything. Our goal in creating and designing a book with this theme is that as the students turn the pages, they grasp the idea that you can be exactly who you want to be and do anything you set your mind to. No goal, dream, or passion is unattainable, no matter what the world may say.
So once again, thank you for being here to support the Western Boone Yearbook. We are so grateful, every single one of us.
Lizzie, they don't know who we is.
Ooh. Please meet the 2017-2018 yearbook staff.
If you could choose any animal for a class pet, what would you choose?
No yearbook class pets. We had a fish once, and it almost died.
What is your favorite yearbook memory?
My absolute favorite yearbook memory was last year we went to Journalism Day at Ball State, and I hung out with Keller all day long, and when we went to Taco Bell for lunch, he got one of those like sauce packets that was blank, and so we wrote, I love you, on it. And then later in the day, we were walking around, and he saw this group of girls, and so he ran up to like these college students, and he tried to give it to the girl, and she was like, no. And she like walked away rapidly faster, and I have it all on video, and you see all the girls laugh, and it is just the funniest thing.
If you could always have one food at your workspace, what food would you choose?
Ice cream and coffee, or coffee ice cream.
If you were in Mr. Weibo, what would be your talent?
I'd probably walk around the stage and talk about birds, but I don't know, because I love birds, but a lot of people don't like birds. Like, I've been finding out that people hate birds, and yeah, so I don't know. I'd probably talk about birds.
If you could always have one food at your workspace, what food would you choose?
Blueberries. I eat them all the time.
If you could always have one food at your workspace, what food would you choose?
Chips and salsa.
If you could choose any animal for a class pet, what would you choose?
Pigs.
If you were Mr. Weibo, what would your talent be?
Beatboxing.
If the yearbook staff could go on a field trip anywhere in the world, where would you want to go?
Scotland, because it's beautiful and I love it.
If you could choose any animal for a class pet, what would you choose?
A baby elephant.
If you were Mr. Weibo, what would be your talent?
Singing, because everyone would laugh, so why not?
What is your favorite yearbook memory?
My favorite yearbook memory was this year with ad sales when Katie was driving us, and she meant to turn into the bowling alley, but she ended up turning into the jail instead and completely flipped out and almost ran over the curb, and then we had to turn around in some sketchy driveway. It was all good though, we got Starbucks.
If you could always have one food at your workspace, what food would you choose?
Definitely french fries. I can eat them like by the pound.
If you could always have one food at your workspace, what food would you choose? If you could always have one food at your workspace, what food would you choose?
Well, I really like food, but if I had to choose one, I'd say a pumpkin roll with an endless supply of white chocolate mochas.
If you could choose any animal for a class pet, what would you choose? And why?
Well, I'd say dolphin, but I don't see how that would work, so a dog, but like a puppy.
Okay. Wait. So now that you know who Evelyn is, let's try this again. Thank you once again for Evelyn coming out to support the Western Boone Yearbook. We are so, so grateful, every single one of us.
I am sure you are already tired of listening to Lizzie and I, so let's get our tan on in the swimsuit portion of this competition.
Southside, got braids in her hair. First
First time I seen her walking by, and I about fell up on my chair. Had to get her number. It took me like 6 weeks. Now me and her go way back, like Cadillac seats. Body like a back row, driving with my eyes closed. I know every curve like the back of my hand. Doing 15 and 30, I ain't in no hurry. I'ma take it slow, just as fast as I can. Why she fitting in blue jeans? She don't need no belt. But I can turn them inside out. Like honey, so thick and so sweet. There ain't no curves like her on them downtown streets. Body like a back road, driving with my eyes closed. I know every curve like the back of my hand. Doing 15 and 30, I ain't in no hurry. I'ma take it slow, just as fast as I can. Tangled up in the tall grass, and my lips on hers. On the highway to heaven, at the south of a smile. Get there when we get there, every inch is a mile. Body like a back road, driving with my eyes closed. I know every curve like the back of my hand. Doing 15 and 30. Just as fast as I can, I'ma take it slow. Just as fast as I can.
Man, our contestants sure do know how to strut with confidence.
I would say they really drop it like it's hot. Well, our boards are preparing themselves for their grand individual showcase. We would like to introduce our wonderful judges of this afternoon's festivities. Audrey Coy, Kelsey Haney, Angie Moody, Eric Ragsdale, Sherry Regal, and Eli Weber.
Audrey Coy is an alumni of Western Moon and an experienced yearbook staff member. She was the editor of the 2013-2014 yearbook publication. This is her first year as a judge, but she understands how much time and effort the boys put into creating their talents and the yearbook staff puts into creating the event.
Kelsey Haney is the wife of English teacher Colin Haney here at Western Boone. She graduated from Indiana University and supports Weibo by coaching the junior high volleyball team. She also spends her time as a youth leader at Eagle Church and watching romantic comedies. Angie Moody is the youth director at Dover Christian Church. She has one child that has graduated from Western Boone, Jordan. She has been a Mr. Weibo judge for 2 years, and we are very glad she is here.
Eric Ragsdale is a returning judge to the Mr. Weibo show. He is also the vice president at the Home National Bank in Thorntown, Indiana. He has had two children graduate from Western Boone, Morgan and Sam. You can find Eric supporting Western Boone students and athletics in various ways, including painting his toenails for the varsity volleyball players. Sherry Regal is the athletic secretary here at Western Boone and a big advocate for school spirit. She has had two daughters graduate from Western Boone, Sydney and Madison.
Eli Weber is an alumni of Western Boone and previously crowned Mr. Congeniality in 2016. He is currently attending Ball State as a sophomore. He is also the brother of our very own advisor, Whitney Weber. His favorite part of Mr. Weibo is the swimsuit portion. We want to give a huge thank you to all of our judges and their willingness to volunteer and help our show.
Thank you.
We would also like to give a huge thank you to Morgan Gray and all of the others helping up in the sound booth right now, helping get our show flowing.
Now to begin everyone's favorite part of the show, the talent section.
Here you are going to see the true personalities of our contestants.
To start us off, we have an experienced magician ready to blow your mind with a simple childhood game. Our first contestant of the afternoon is Reese Thompson.
His trick is not disappearing, believe it or not. We don't have any stall time. We used all of our jokes in the beginning. Talk about football. Oh, yes, if you haven't already heard, our football team played Tipton, yes, Tipton, on Friday in the second round of sectionals, and the boys, with 45 seconds left in the game, scored, causing us to win, and we will go into our third round of sectionals, or final round, the championship game. Against Park Tudor, I knew that one. Against Park Tudor this Friday night. However, there, yay! We have three boys in our contestant lineup. We have Dalton Brown, Patrick Schellenberger, and Zach Anderson on the football team. This Friday night, there's also the Pops Choir concert here at Western Boone. We are struggling with the difficulty in that it conflicts with this sectional championship game, but we also have choir members on our contestant list too.
Reese Thompson, ladies and gentlemen.
So you guys are familiar with playing tic-tac-toe, right?
No.
X's and O's. All right, your name is?
Eli.
Eli, and this is?
Rags.
So Eli and Rags are gonna play some tic-tac-toe. So Rags, you can go first. Do you wanna be X's or O's?
O's.
O's? So where would you like to go?
Right there.
In the top right corner with an X? Oh, okay. So, where would you like to go?
Right here.
Bottom left corner with a red O. And where would you like to put your X? In the bottom right. Where would you like to put your O? In the right middle. And you would like to put your next X in the top left. Where would you like to put your next O? Ooh. Looks like Rags might have you on this one.
Here.
Oh, I think you can only get one. So right in the top middle. So where would you like to put your last X? I think it's quite obvious.
I don't know. Right there.
In the middle. He puts an X in the middle and Rags wins.
Sorry, man.
Yes, you can go take a seat now. So that was fun. Time for magic. Okay. So what I have for you, I have a soda can. As you can see, is unopened. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to dent it. So it's an old dented soda can. And I'm going to make it new.
Obvious.
game of tic-tac-toe. So I think we had a successful trial for you at Mr. Weebo. And I think that's all I have for you.
Wait, it was in his shoe the entire time? I don't even know how that happens. We don't know how you do it, Reese. Our next contestant, Barton Martin, is ready to be a dad. Well, only his humor, we hope.
Are the mics on? Oh, yeah. Here we go. Okay. Well, for starters, you want to know the best part about technology? When your announcer steals your joke. I'm not mad, I'm just disappointed. I'm reading a book about anti-gravity. It's impossible to put down. Want to hear a joke about a piece of paper? Never mind, it's terrible. If you see someone rob an Apple store, are you considered an eyewitness? A ham sandwich walks into a bar and orders a water. Bartender says, "Sorry, we don't serve food here." Why couldn't the bike stand up? It was too tired. What did the horse say when it fell? "Help, I've fallen and I can't giddy up." Do you know French fries weren't actually cooked in France? They were cooked in Greece. I had a dream last night that I was a muffler. I woke up exhausted. Why do chicken coops only have two doors? Because if they had four, it would be a chicken sedan. That's all I have. Thanks, folks.
Hey, Ready? Hey, Lizzie, don't you have a pretty good dad joke? Okay, guys, this is my time. Most of you have heard it 1.5 million times, but ready? What did the janitor say when he came out of the closet? Supplies! Now that Lizzie has told the entire world her best dad joke, let's get artsy. Our next contestant is Zach Neff, and he is showcasing his inner art he found in himself about 3 weeks ago. Here's the time lapse of him painting one of his very first pieces of artwork.
happy little trees. Oh, hi, I'm Bob Ross. I have viewers write in all the time and tell me about the wonderful little paintings they create. And today I'm going to show you a video of one of my favorite students, Zach Neff, painting a happy little picture. Enjoy. From watching Bob Ross videos, I've learned how to paint, and today I'm going to create a happy little picture. Enjoyed Zach Neff's wonderful little painting. Thanks for watching. Happy painting and God bless.
Well, I don't know about Zach, but if I were him, I would sign that piece and sell it because he can make some good money.
I would pay the whole $10 in my bank account for it. Actually, maybe he should sell it to someone with a steady income.
Up next is my favorite contestant, Duncan Reed. I'm pretty sure his parents named him Duncan for this exact moment.
Here we go.
Well, Duncan, we are very, very glad you didn't fall off that trampoline for more than one reason.
If you didn't see who was driving the small car, that would be Michael Dunn. Our fifth contestant is Adam Meadows, and he will be starting off the afternoon's first of many musical talents. Adam is here playing Plush by Stone Temple Pilots on his very own bass guitar.
Thank you.
performance, Adam. Thank you for starting our music off on the right beat. I don't know if anyone remembers last year or not, but Michael Dunn is here and ready to take you, but not ready to take you back into the best TV shows from the 80s and 2000s. Instead, he'll be taking us through what he thinks are the best movies of the 80s.
Welcome to the National American Institute for the Advancement of the Arts, specifically the advancement of theatrical performances from the 1980s. Please be quiet and do not touch the artifacts.
Quickly before, or quite like that. Do you remember when I played the trumpet for like 3 years?
Yeah, why'd you quit that?
Well, my mom would tell you that I wasn't very good, and I couldn't disagree. However, I think our next contestant, Devin Vickery, is 12 times the trumpeteer.
Are you sure it's Devin?
In the spirit of Halloween, I may be wrong.
Here, playing his own theme song, it's a Mario. Talent than I did.
Me too, Luce. To continue with our musically inclined contestants, is Zach Anderson ready to wow you with all the 5,000 candles in the wind from the television show Parks and Rec?
Thank you. So how's everyone doing tonight? All right, so this one goes out to all the horse lovers, miniature horse lovers, pony lovers, and of course to you, little Sebastian, and all the great things you did for Pawnee, Indiana.
The thing you trade your legs for angels' wings, and once we've all said goodbye, you take a run and leap and you learn to fly. Bye bye, little Sebastian, we'll miss you in the saddest fashion. Sebastian, your 5,000 candles in the wind. And though we'll miss you every day, we know you're up there eating heaven's hay. And here's the part that hurts the most. Humans cannot ride a ghost. Bye bye, little Sebastian, miss you in the saddest fashion. Bye bye, little Sebastian, your 5,000 candles in the wind. Everybody sing it now. Bye bye, little Sebastian. Miss you in the saddest fashion. Bye bye, little Sebastian. Your 5,000 candles in the wind. Maybe someday we'll saddle up again. And I know I'll always miss my horsiest friend. Spread your wings and fly, spread your wings and fly.
Thank you.
Wow, after that performance, I really understand why Zach is in Star Voices.
Patrick Schellenberger is another Star Voices member, and he is brand new to playing the guitar. He started playing a few weeks ago, but loves the meaning behind this song. Here, ready to share it with you, Patrick Schellenberger.
Souls that are lost in crime, the rails of sin, only evil remains. Watch out, brother, for that long black train. Look to the heavens, you can look to the skies. You can find redemption staring back into your eyes. There is protection and there's peace the same. A burning in your ticket for that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory. Father and his holy name, and don't go riding on that long black train. There's an engineer on that long black train, making you wonder if your ride is worth the pain. He's just waiting on your hard to say, let me ride on that long black train. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and his holy name, and don't go riding on that long black train. Well, I can hear the whistle from a mile away. It sounds so good, but I must stay away. That train is a beauty, making everybody stare. But its only destination is the middle of nowhere. But you know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and his holy name. And don't go riding on that long black train. I said, cling to the Father and His holy name, and don't go riding on that long black train. Yeah, watch out, Weebo, for that long black train. That devil's a driving that long black train.
A little more after that performance.
So, remember how we told you most of our boys were musically inclined? Well, meet another one, Dalton Brown, a saxophone player of 8 years, here to play Careless Whisper. Can't you, Dalton? Miles Clutter, our next contestant, is here to represent the Western Boone Yearbook staff as an honorary member.
Attending all our parties and meetings as Weber's assistant, we are excited to hear for you to hear his beautiful voice singing Porti Volare from the movie Step Brothers with the help of Felix Martinez.
Thank you. palabras. En la sombra entre luces todo es negro para mi mirada. Si tú no estás junto a mí aquí, tú en tu mundo separado del mío por un abismo. Llámame, yo volaré tu mundo lejano por ti. Tu amor, abriendo los ojos por fin, contigo viviré, cuando solo soleado por mi mirada, en la luna lecha por ahí, ahí, una luna lecha por mí, una luna lecha por mí. Espera que llegaré. Mi fin de trayecto es tú, para vivirlo los dos por ti. Volaré por cielos y mares hasta tu amor, abriendo los ojos por fin. Cielos y mares hasta tu amor, abriendo los ojos por fin, contigo viviré por ti, volaré por cielos y mares hasta tu amor.
Oh, John, you've done it again. We are so proud of you. Next up, and our 12th most confident contestant is Dalton Davis. He is ready to share his passion of the cattle industry with y'all.
How's everybody doing tonight? Great. All right, so I'm going to be doing a little bit of auctioneering for you tonight. We're going to be auctioning off this fine bovine. But before I say a few things, let's go ahead and give my escort, Jet McClaskey, a round of applause. All right, so for this to work, to be fun, and to be efficient, we're going to need a little bit of crowd participation, especially the judges. I'm going to be the only one calling bids, so I'll make eye contact when you see it, but be patient since I'm the only one up here. And I think let's get started. All right, lot one coming into the sale ring now. Lot one, everybody turn to your tables, lot one. All right, we're gonna start it at $1,000 and do $500 bids. $1,000, 500 bids. All right, let's go. Here, 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 now one and a half. Here, 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 one, here, one and a half. Now here, 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 $2,000, now here, two and a half. Here, 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 three, here, three, here, three and a half. Here, 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 three, now gotta be three and a half. Now four, now five. Here, 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 $5,000, here, 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 $5,500, here, 5,000, now 7, now 8. Come on, folks, it's only money. Let's go. Here now, here, but 9 to 5. Here, but 9. Here, but 10. But 10. But $10,000. Here, 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 but 10. Here, but 10 and a half. Here, here, but 10. Here, but 11. Here, but $11,000. Here, here, but 12. Here, but 12. But 12. Come on, don't hesitate. Participate. Let's go. Here, but 12. But 12. But 12. Here, but $12,000. Now, here, but 13. Here, but 14. Here, but 14. But $14,000. Now, here, but 15. Here, now 16. Here, but 16,000. Now 17, 18, 19. $19,000. 20. Here, but 20. But 20. But 20. But 20. $20,000 and everybody 20 with a $21,000, 22, everybody 23, everybody 24, everybody 24, now 25, everybody 25 going once, twice. What's that? 50,000. 50,000. Looks like she left the husband and brought the check. All right, $50,000 going once, twice, three times. You bought it. Lot one goes to buyer number 229, lady in the black shirt. Thank you very much.
I talk pretty fast, but not like you, Dalton.
Our last, but definitely not least, contestant of the afternoon is previous Mr. Congeniality, Felix Martinez, playing Under the Sea on his handmade tubulum.
Hello.
Favorite movie, and Felix, you did it justice. Well done.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we've met the boys and we have seen them showcase their talents, but now it's time to get down to the real deal, the formal questions.
Each boy, escorted by the lady of his choice, will come back onto the stage in his best-looking attire to be asked two questions, a silly question and a serious question.
We have prepared the serious questions for each boy and we will ask the escort to pick a question out of the silly hat. Are we ready?
Our first contestant is Reese Thompson, the magician. He would like to go to IUPUI to study criminal justice. He is escorted by Caitlin Kaufman. Reese, first, your serious question. What is the biggest life lesson you have learned from soccer?
The biggest life lesson I've learned from soccer, first of all, we've never had that great of a soccer season, but you can't base a soccer season off of your record. It's the compatibility with the teammates and what makes it a great season, not the record.
And for his silly question, picked by his lovely escort, it is, what would you name your boat if you had one?
Well, I think I'd have to name my boat Jenny off of Forrest Gump, because what else would you name it? And it's a classic. Everybody's seen Forrest Gump, and everybody's watched it multiple times, so why not Jenny?
Is comedian Barton Martin being escorted by Jayla Marsh. Barton Martin is looking forward to his senior year and living in the moment. Barton, your serious question is, what made you want to do the fall play?
Well, I just thought it sounded fun and I want to try out acting a little bit, so.
And for your silly question, it is, what board games always end badly for you?
Monopoly. Everybody gets all mad because, you know, everybody wants to be banker, everybody wants to be car. And then it lasts like 4 hours and nobody wants to talk to each other anymore. Ruins friendships.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Being escorted by Maggie Klingensmith, we have the artist Zach Neff, who is planning to attend Purdue University to study forestry and wildlife.
Okay, Zach, for your serious question, it is, although tennis is an individual sport, what has it taught you about teamwork?
Tennis has taught me that teamwork is necessary to kind of communicate with others, and it really gives you a lot of traits that you wouldn't have had working alone.
For your silly question, if you could know the absolute and total truth to only one question, what question would you ask?
What's the answer to world peace?
ultimate basketball star is being escorted by Katie Potter. Duncan is intending to attend Ball State for architecture.
Right there's good.
Okay, Duncan. That microphone is okay for you. Your serious question is, as Key Club president, what is the most inspiring part?
The most inspiring part about Key Club and just being involved in everything in general is the idea that you get when you do something good. My biggest project that I've done is Black Friday shopping. We go to Menards on Black Friday to shop for the Humane Society. And when you're getting all these, you know, big goodies, it's fun, always fun to go Black Friday shopping and stuff. But then when you take that to the Humane Society and you see all these animals here that nobody has or that nobody, you know, wants, and it really gets you in this, that feeling when you see good coming from what you've done. There's no comparison.
If you had to change your name, what would your new name be, and why would you choose that name?
I'd probably have to say Miles Clutter, because I just think that's a pretty awesome name. I'm not sure where it's coming from, but it just sounds like a really cool guy named Miles Clutter.
And bass player Adam Meadows is escorted by Hannah Sevier. In his future, he wants to join the Navy, and after serving, he would like to become a police officer.
Adam, your serious question is: what has inspired you to join the Navy?
Almost all people in my family have either been in the Air Force. Like, I have an uncle who's a major. I have a grandma, rest her soul. She was a captain, a nurse in the Army. I had two grandpas who were in World War II. One was in Iwo Jima, one was in Normandy, I think. And they were all in the Army. And what inspired me was carrying on the family tradition, honor my country and respect. And also, I had an uncle who graduated here in 88, I think. He was in Desert Storm. So I have lots of family history with the military.
Yeah. What innovative piece of technology do you hope is invented in your lifetime?
What was the first part of that?
What innovative piece of technology do you hope is invented in your lifetime?
Well, I saw this movie, I think it was called Elysium, with Matt Damon, and it had this machine that cured any disease. So I would have to say that.
Thank you. My wonderful locker neighbors, we have 80s enthusiast Michael Dunn being escorted by Maddie Flory. Michael wants to earn his doctorate for physical therapy starting at the University of Indianapolis.
Michael, for your serious question, it is, what is more challenging, maintaining a good GPA or being a top athlete?
See, the big thing with that is time management, because there's only 24 hours in a day, and sometimes I feel like I need 48. But I would say GPA, because I always try and push myself in everything that I do, and that includes academics. And so that also means some homework and some late nights, but I've been willing to put in that extra work.
Hey, Michael Dunn, what is your favorite pickup line?
In the words of Joey Tribbiani, how you doing?
Up next, we have Devin Vickery, the trumpeter, and his beautiful escort, Katie Baker. Devin wants to go to Purdue to study chemical engineering. Devin, how has band disciplined you as a person?
Band has disciplined me as a person because in a way that I have to discipline myself by going home and practicing to make sure that the entire band doesn't sound bad, because if one person sounds bad, the entire band sounds bad.
Okay, Devin, if you were arrested with no explanation as of why, what would your friends and family assume you would have done? Would you like us to read it again?
Sure, why not?
If you were arrested with no explanation as of why, what would your friends and family assume you had done?
Boy. I assume that they would think that I was innocent.
Okay, up next, Mary Brownlee is escorting our eighth contestant, guitar-playing Zach Anderson. Zach is taking time to think about his future at the moment, but plans to attend IU.
Zach, after graduation, do you plan to pursue music just as passionately as you do now?
Of course I do. I don't think it'll be a main course of study for me in the future, as the music program at IU is very prestigious and difficult to get into, but definitely as a hobby and a pastime, because as I am so passionate about it now, I hope that that continues on for the rest of my life.
If you don't like this question, you can blame Mary. If you could make any activity an Olympic sport, what would it be and why?
Ooh. I would have to say binge watching on Netflix.
We all agree on that one. Thank you, Zach.
Thank you, Zach. Here's Madison Hodgen escorting country music artist Patrick Schellenberger. Patrick plans to win state back-to-back and then eventually study a science field at Indiana University.
Thank you, Lucy.
Okay, Patrick, what has being so involved in so many extracurricular activities taught you about time management?
That's a great, great, great question, Lizzie.
Thank you.
Being involved in so many extracurricular activities has taught me that it's not good to procrastinate and stay up till 3 a.m. doing your homework when you have a football game the next day, especially when you're practicing a song for Mr. Weibo and you play the number one team in the class 2A on the next day and you're up till 3 a.m. trying to figure out how to play the guitar because you've only been playing for a week and a half.
If you could eliminate any inanimate object in the world, what would you eliminate?
What a great, great, great question, Lucy. If I could eliminate any object in this world, I'd probably eliminate world hunger. Honestly, that's a serious question. Not to be funny about that, even though this is a silly question. I feel like all these children in other countries, third world countries that are starving, compared to that of what we have in the United States, we could say we're kind of spoiled. And I seriously, I think we need to help out a little more. I mean, we should all be equal, right?
Thank you, Patrick.
Thank you.
Next is Dalton Brown, our sax player, being escorted by Merrill Gorley. Dalton Brown plans to study business administration at IUPUI or Ball State.
Thank you.
Sorry, Dalton. Okay, Dalton, so knowing that it's your last year playing football, how has it made you play differently?
I've definitely put more effort into it, knowing that it could be my last game now that we are in playoffs. You know, it's win or go home, so I definitely don't want it to end, so I'll keep fighting for it.
How do you feel about putting pineapple on your pizza?
Don't. Just don't.
Thank you. Miles Clutter is here, escorted by Brooke Cummins, and he is planning on going into the military in his future.
Okay, Miles, can you describe how choir has impacted your life?
Well, choir has just, first of all, I never really wanted to do choir. I was kind of roped into it by my mom, but it came at a rough time in my life, and it gave me a big emotional outlet and just helped me express myself.
What is the dumbest way that you have ever been injured?
Well, I've had multiple head injuries, but I guess the most significant was running into a pole in my aunt's basement. My brother threw me a football, but I think he led me a little bit too much.
Thank you.
Up next, we have Dalton Davis, the auctioneer, escorted by Jet McClaskey. Dalton is looking to study agriculture economics at Purdue University in his future.
Dalton, what have you learned about leadership from showing livestock for so many years?
Good question. What's one thing I've learned about leadership? That's one thing I would say is don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to take that position, because as we all know in life, it's probably 100% sure we're going to fail at some point. And if you go with that mindset going in, knowing that you're probably going to mess up, it's going to be okay. Because you know, if you're a good leader, you have support behind you to push you and motivate you to be a better leader and overcome the failure with more and more greater successes.
Okay, Dalton, what would be the coolest animal to scale up to size of a horse?
I think the coolest animal to scale up to size to a horse, just because they're so small and so ferocious, is probably a chihuahua. If you can imagine that thing, the size of a horse, that'd be quite the sight.
Thank you. Finally, we have our tubulum player, Felix Martinez, with his escort, Riley Burns. He plans to study political science at IU or Notre Dame, and then enter into the ROTC and join the Army.
Okay, Felix, for your formal question, after all of the volunteer work you do, which one is your favorite and why?
I'd say my favorite volunteer work is working with the junior high baseball team, because you get to really interact with something that you love and people that love doing what you do too.
Of all your pet peeves, which is the strangest?
Of all my pet peeves, I'd say when somebody doesn't wear a hat right. So, you know, if it has like the stitching on the back and they're wearing it forward, you should probably flip that around so you can look good.
Thank you.
Thank you, Felix.
The judges will now tally the scores, so we are going to have a short intermission. Feel free to get up, stretch, and make it back into the auditorium within the next 20 minutes.
We wish good luck to all of our contestants.
All right, guys. Thanks for joining us for the intermission here. I'm Colin Burns, along with Matt Mitchell, Jake McGee, and Trevin Popowell. We're going to give a little recap now. So, guys, what do you think about those performances out there?
You know, being from another school, coming here to just visit and see how the Mr. Weibo is represented by Weibo, I'd say it's a pretty good show, and I'd like to carry it on to Crawfordsville. You know, it's a pretty good show. I like how it's run and everything.
Kind of like a Mr. Athenian type thing.
Almost about that, like
that,
yeah.
Do you guys have any talent show, any type of talent show to Crawfordsville?
I believe we have a talent show. I myself have not been to it. We don't really have a broadcast to broadcast any, so it's not really that big. Just people and their parents, me, it seems like. But, yeah, so... Trevin, I like this.
Trevin, what did you think about the swimsuit portion?
Oh, the swimsuit portion, it was great. I mean, some people had some pretty funny acts. Reese Thompson, for example, had the wings. Dylan Brown had some sweatpants, and he just threw them off to the judges. It was quite funny.
Yeah, I was a little bit nervous about that for a minute. I didn't know where that was going to go.
Bunch of high school guys in swimsuits, you never know.
Yeah. Oh, man. Well, hey, the dad jokes are pretty funny, too.
Yeah, Bart Martin carried on pretty well.
Yeah, Bart, yeah, he did pretty good with the dad jokes.
Even though one of the judges stole his jokes.
Oh, yeah.
So you want to meet some of our contestants? We got them down here. We can go with...
Bringing Dalton Brown.
We're going to bring Dalton Brown here and see how he thought he did. Let's give him a mic. So, Dalton, how do you think you did?
I think I did pretty well. You know, I feel like it might not have sounded like it, but... It's hard to tell if you don't know music as well as people who are in band do.
So what was your favorite part about performing today?
Definitely the dance. The dance was the most fun. Whenever we get together and practice it, it's always fun because some of us are really bad at dancing, so yeah.
Okay, and yeah, you played the saxophone, right?
Yeah.
You went out there and played the saxophone. Like, why do you like the saxophone so much?
I've always kind of liked jazz, and I started in fifth grade, and I just fell in love with it. It looks complicated, but it's really not once you get used to it.
Is there, like, a specific act that you're worried about stopping you from winning Mr. Weibo today?
Not really. I think I did well in all of them, so hopefully, you know, can win this.
What kind of mindset do you have, like, while you're performing each, you know, thing, segment, or, like, answering a question?
I just kind of pretend that the crowd's not there, so I'm not as nervous, and just don't be shy about it. Just go out and do it.
Well, good luck to you.
Good luck to you.
We'll go next to Zach Neff.
Zach, you're a pretty good artist, man. I never knew like you had that artistic nature.
Thank you.
And what? How long did it take you to paint that?
Well, the actual painting took me about 2 days, but I started painting like 3 weeks ago, and I've just been learning from there.
You made a lot of improvement in the last like 3 weeks.
Thank you.
It's been really good.
That's quite impressed. So you said you learned from a guy named John Ross, am I correct?
Bob Ross. John Ross,
painter.
We ain't talking about the NFL now.
So like how, like where did you like find Mr. Ross?
Bob? Well, you can see him on TV and on YouTube. Okay. So I spend a lot of time in class.
Pretty sure he's on Netflix too, is he not?
I believe he is, yeah.
Yeah, he's on a painting show.
So when did you first begin to get interested in Bob Ross?
I've always thought Bob Ross was pretty cool, but I've been watching some Bob Ross on TV lately and got more interested.
That's pretty interesting, man. I like the little wig you went with.
Thank you.
All right, we're going to bring over Devin Vickery now. Zach, thanks for...
Good luck.
Good luck.
Hi, Devin. How are you doing?
Doing pretty well. How about you?
Pretty good. Did you feel any nerves while you were out there, like in front of that crowd? Like, did you ever pay attention to them, really?
Yeah, because you see when you're up there playing and you have like a mustache like clogging your breathing nose, it's kind of hard to play, and knowing which notes I missed, that just drove me nuts.
And you guys got anything else for him? I mean,
what made you do the Mario theme song?
Like I said in the other interview before this, me and Felix Martinez dressed up during the Twin Tuesday for homecoming week, whenever that was, and I just played the whole song, played the song most of the day, and then I just thought, hey, might as well play it for Mr. Weibo.
Why not? I thought it was pretty good.
Thank you.
It was really good.
Let's take a look at another one of our contestants. Let's bring over Michael Dunn. So, Michael, you did the movie impressions. What did you think? How did you think you did today?
Well, I think I did my best. You know, I had a lot of moving parts and a lot of things could have gone wrong, but I think we turned out all right.
I thought it was pretty good. Pretty good.
There's a lot of movies from the 80s. Like, how did you decide which ones to go with?
Well, you know, in my mind, it's one of the best generations, and my parents showed me a lot of those movies. So it's kind of been a personal thing for me and them, and they're just iconic, you know.
So I know you performed last year, Mr. Rebo. Did you have any nerves going into Mr. Rebo this year?
Well, it definitely helped having a year under my belt, but there's always nerves because little things can go wrong, but I think we had a really successful performance.
That's pretty great.
Mm-hmm. We're going to bring over Patrick Schallenberger now.
Good luck, Michael.
Don't act so nervous
Good
there
luck,
over
Michael.
Pat.
Oh, Patrick, we got some questions for you.
Thank you for having me today, guys.
How long have you been playing guitar, Patrick?
I think I've been playing guitar for about 7-8 years now.
Come on, don't lie to me.
Is that a fact?
Just kidding. I started playing right before fall break. I was just tried teaching myself.
And you learned how to play a song already?
Yeah. This song on the guitar was not like a super expert level song. It was kind of intermediate, even though I had a couple flukes, but I thought I did all right. Just nerves were flying everywhere.
Did you want to play guitar before Mr. Weibo, or did you hear about it and like, I want to play guitar for my talent?
Well, I got a guitar in sixth grade, and I thought I was going to actually like start learning how to play, but I went through a couple lessons, and I never really got into it, I guess. My mindset just wasn't there up to what now I want to play now today.
How hard was it to balance football and playing the guitar in that short time to get ready for this contest?
Well, if you sleep 4 hours a night, then it's not that hard.
Okay.
Fall break was a really big help for Mr. Weibo. With all this time off, I didn't have to focus on school. That really got me prepared. I called a couple people that I knew how to play guitar and had them come over and kind of help me a little bit. And just like what I said up on stage, I don't know if you guys heard that question, but the night before the Tipton game, I would tell 2:30, 3 o'clock, just practicing the song. I just had nerves flying.
Well, you had a good game, so you probably got some film study in there too, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. I had an essay I had to write, and I had a project for PCC. I watched some huddle, and then I just practiced the song more than anything.
Oh, man. Well, man, that must be tough. We're going to bring over Dalton Davis now.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Good luck.
Good luck.
We have an auctioneer, Mr. Dalton Davis.
What's going on?
Oh, Mr. Davis, I appreciated your auctioneering out there. I thought it was a really good job
out there.
Thank
you, I appreciate it.
Really like that.
Very original.
What inspired you to do auctioneer as your talent?
So, you know, growing up on a farm and going to a lot of cattle sales and stuff, you hear it, and it's kind of just cool to listen to, I think. And I haven't taken any classes or nothing. I've kind of just self-taught myself, you know. Like when I'm at home kind of sitting around, I'll goof around and play with it a little bit, or watch some YouTube videos on it, and kind of just kept doing it and doing it. And I thought it was original, got the crowd involved, so I thought that'd be my talent.
So now, like, I don't really know that much about like auctioneering or anything. Can you tell me like what makes a good auctioneer?
Well, part of it is basically just your auction chants, and basically your one-liners. Your auction chants are there to make the crowd want to bid more. And like for my talent, I had nobody lined up to bid or nothing, so that was all just kind of winging out there, hoping people would do it. But like some of my one-liners, you know, were like, come on folks, it's only money. Like when it's dying down, you know, it makes them want to get going again. And basically you're a good auctioneer if you can just sell it to the best of your ability.
Have you ever done it before, like
in an actual setting?
I have not, in front of
no.
people?
I think when I get older though, I'd like to go to auctioneer school for a few weeks and not necessarily do it for a career, but just kind of know how to do it on the side and stuff.
Oh, that'd be really
sounds like fun.
Yeah.
All right, thanks, Dalton. We'll bring you over Duncan Reed.
Good luck, Dalton, to you.
Duncan, how's it going, boys?
How you doing? It's going pretty good. How are you guys doing?
I like that. Nice
colorful tie.
Oh, there thanks, bro. Flowers. This is my favorite tie. It's my, yeah. It really was a nice kind of roses. A second. That's my favorite, but the whole suit was just my second choice because I realized only yesterday that my black suit was in the dry cleaner, so I had to go with the charcoal gray. Not to be confused with black.
You're being depicted Air Jordan on one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Like Mike.
Don't expect anything like that this season. just gonna.
You can't use your athletic ability actually on the court.
We're gonna have to take that one up with IHSAA and drop the goal down a couple feet. Then we're talking. You guys back me up on that, and I'll give it my.
I will support you just so I can see that.
Thanks, Richard.
So what like made you be like, oh, I want to dunk?
Because I have no real talents.
I'm sure you have some talent.
Yeah, I get up on stage and I'm like, what can I do that's going to make people go,
you can do the worm.
That's fun. Like, thanks, Jake.
Yeah, there
do
you
the
go.
Worm. I'm just going to do the worm for like 2.5 minutes. No, I thought it was just something interesting, something different, something new. And my objective coming in here, and I mean, I don't want to say I didn't want to win, but that's not my main objective. My main objective was to come out, rep my school, rep my colors, and have a good time doing it. And I thought that's something I love doing. Let's do it. See if people like it.
That's great.
That's a great message.
We're going to bring over the father of all jokes.
Oh,
we're
going to bring over Bart Martin. All right, here we go, guys. Martin, thank you very much.
Thanks,
you.
Man.
Good
Martin
luck.
Martin.
Bar, how you doing?
I'm doing great. What's popping, guys?
That's great.
So can you tell us what jokes specifically they stole from you?
Well, it was, what does an angry pepper do? It gets jalapeno face.
Broach.
I was pretty salty when they said it, but, you know.
Oh, man. Where'd you come up with those jokes, man? Did you, like, pull them from the internet? Or
Google.
Find everything off the internet.
Oh, man. Well, okay. So, like, what made you think, like, that was a pretty good talent? Like, what made you think that kind of gave you an edge?
The fact that I have no other talents.
It's funny. Man, like, confident.
Untalented people.
What untalented people in a talent show.
A lot of untalented people.
Oh, man. Oh, Bart. That was pretty interesting, you know? I mean, the dad jokes are great. I don't know if a lot of people got the terrible one, you know,
the paper.
The paper. Oh, the paper.
Yes. I thought it was good.
It took me a little bit to get it, but I got it.
So you like, for the people who didn't get it, could you like explain a little bit?
You can tear paper.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. There you go, Trent.
Oh, that was a good
thanks,
one.
Thanks, Bart. We're going to bring up Miles Clutter.
Miles Clutter.
I love you, Miles.
Okay.
He loves Miles.
Good luck, Bart.
Hey, guys.
How you doing, Miles?
So what song did he sing?
I sang the song Por Ti Volare from the movie Step Brothers by Andrea Bocelli.
What inspired you to choose that song?
Well, I've always been a fan of the movie, and I think it's a beautiful song.
Very beautiful.
How long did it take you to learn that?
Well, I knew the main few lines, the chorus, for a while because I listened to the song regularly, but just in the last week, I had to memorize the rest of the song.
Oh. Did a pretty good job of it, I'll tell you that.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah.
Not a problem.
You had some pretty high notes there towards the end. I was surprised. I
actually had to edit the song. It was a little too high.
Yeah.
And I had to bring it down so my voice didn't crack as much.
It's a very dramatic ending.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you. That's what I was doing.
Everybody Zach loved Anderson.
All right, football thank player you, again, Zach Anderson. Yeah.
Good luck. Hello, Zach. Mr. Anderson.
Hello.
Zach, you sang a pretty beautiful song, man. I'm not going to lie. Tugged on my heart a little bit. Pretty interesting.
What made you decide to choose this song?
Okay, well, I was thinking about doing a different song the entire like month leading up to Mr. Rebo. I was going to do the song Everglow by Coldplay, and I was going to play it on the piano. However, kind of like Miles' situation, that song is really high, and it's just hard for me to hit comfortably, and the piano is much more complex than the guitar, so Wednesday, about 5 minutes before I told Miss Webber exactly what I was going to do, I'm like, I just changed my song.
So you know how to play the piano, though, right?
Yes.
Like, a little bit?
A little bit.
You know, like, any songs or, like, any, like, you know, I'm not talking about, like, some nursery rhymes. I'm talking
about
like
his specialty.
Like, yeah. Like, some, you know, more, like, mainstream type songs.
My go-to songs are generally songs by Coldplay, or my personal favorite and now is probably Drops of Jupiter by Train.
So what draws you to Coldplay?
It's just they're very easy to play on the piano because everything they do is piano based, whereas some songs are more
based on guitar with a bass and a drum. Coldplay has a lot of theirs just straight up melody and chords on piano.
Well, we're going to bring over another musical artist. We're going to bring over Adam Meadows, standing over here. He's going to come on over. And Zach, thank you.
Thank you. Good luck, Zach.
Good luck.
All right, how are you doing there, Adam? I mean, that was pretty good performance, I thought. You know, being a solo bass, you know. How difficult is that to do solo with a bass?
Well, since I had the wig on, I couldn't see my fretboard, so I was just going straight in. I couldn't see it at all, so I might have messed up a few times, but...
So how'd you feel going into the show?
I wasn't really nervous until I actually went on there at all. Unfortunately.
It happens.
So, but I kind of hid behind the wig, wasn't that nervous after that. So, threw in the head big at the very end, went on my knees, you know, did a little thing, solo. it was like...
I really liked the wig, brought out like a whole different personality in the bass.
Yeah.
I liked that a lot.
Like how you kind of switched up to like the grunge type.
I had the Nirvana shirt on.
Yeah.
And the flannel.
Mm-hmm. So what like made you choose that song?
I was originally going to play Say It Ain't So by Weezer, but I couldn't remember it for the life of me, but I couldn't know that one. So I just decided to do that one.
Hmm.
All right, what was your favorite part about the swimsuit competition that you had?
I would have to say the little thing me and Felix had there.
You
had to build the little castle, the cups, so I'd kick it over.
That's kind of mean.
Yeah, well,
uncalled for.
Would be so aggressive, picking the aggressive music and then being aggressive in nature. We're going to bring over Felix Martinez. I'm going to talk to us for a little bit. Adam, thanks, and good luck to you.
Yeah, good luck.
Felix, how you doing?
How you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you guys doing?
We're doing pretty good. All right, tell us about that swimsuit competition. Did you feel pretty confident going to that?
You know, I think everybody loves a man who can, you know, throw it back to way too far back, you know, they can think about their grandfather. It's like, hey, that guy looks like my grandfather. That's pretty cool.
So you're trying to be a grandfather.
Yes. Trying to go for the grandfather type.
Everybody's grandfather. That really warms my heart.
No, I really like the...
There you go.
I really like the mermaid you came out in. How long did it take you to make that instrument?
That instrument alone took me about a week, so it took me about all fall break. I was planning on just 2 days, but, you know, some changes had to be made.
I thought you played it pretty well. Made it pretty well, seemed like, too.
Oh, thank you.
Now, did you make it, or did your parents make it?
That was me making it with a lot of help from a woodworking standpoint and teaching me a lot through it from my dad and Greg Gillum. He was a lot of help to me.
Okay.
So is he, Greg Gillum, close family friend to you?
Yeah, I'd say they're pretty close. Pretty cool people.
So I know before the show you said you were most worried about Zach Anderson, but after the show now, after seeing all the acts, who are you most, is there a new... that you're worried about?
Well, man, I wouldn't say I was worried about Zach Anderson. I'd say I was pretty excited to watch him. I think he did a really great job, and I think Zach Anderson won it all. Beautiful singing right there.
Well, I think the results are in shortly. Felix, we're going to go ahead and let you go. Thanks for agreeing to this interview, and thank you to all the guys who agreed to this interview as well. Once again, I'm Colin Bruins. This is Jake McGee, Matt Mitchell, Trent Popwell with the intermission. We're going to send it back to the auditorium for the results.
Stage, the yearbook staff would like to give one more big thank you to all the boys for volunteering to participate in the show this year, and for the judges for their spending their afternoon here with us, and for you for supporting our program and paying for the tickets and being here.
Okay, so now for what you all really care about, the winners. First, we'll announce Mr. Congeniality, whom is voted for by the boys themselves. Okay, Mr. Congeniality of 2017 is Duncan Reed and Barton Martin.
please, Lizzie? Your 2017 Mr. Weibo is Michael Dunn! With your friends and family, we're going to ask that you stay on stage to take a few pictures for the yearbook, of course, and an interview with Mr. Foxworthy. Thank you one last time to everyone who came to support us this afternoon.
It was such a fun and exciting show, and we hope that you had a wonderful time.
Well, that was a surprise. I've never seen two Mr. Congenialities before.
No, it's very surprised. Barton Martin, and I believe it was Duncan Reed, am I correct?
Yeah, that was correct.
Mr. Congeniality.
Yeah.
And the winner, Michael Dunn. Pretty good show for the boys today.
That was an upset. I really thought Felix or Zach Anderson was going to have it on this game for this competition.
I thought Dalton Davis did a pretty good job auctioneering. I thought he got the crowd intrigued, and right now they're getting a good picture together.
It takes a lot of guts to be able to do this because this is so much time and preparation. Like, they don't have, like, they have the same work that we do and everything, and they have all this to add on to it. And some are
a lot of these guys are fall athletes.
Yeah,
too.
Yeah, and like at least
tons of stuff going on, you know. And for them to come out here and do this, you know, it's just congratulations to them even for trying. You know, it's a great group of guys.
All talented, even though some said that they weren't very talented at all. The judges, though, I think Audrey Coy, Kelsey Haney, Angie Moody,
Eric Ragsdale, Sherry Rigel, and Elijah Weber.
Correct, it was Sherry Rigel.
Oh, my apologies.
I assume that they thought Michael Dunn was the winner, and I guess it was his movies. I mean, Ferris Bueller's Day Off, his little twist and shout by the Beatles.
He did a very good job.
Got the crowd going.
I like the Indiana Jones impression of him. Running with the yellow ball coming behind him, I thought it was pretty good.
I just thought Dawn Davis and his like, it was so original, like
auctioneering.
Like, I'm surprised that the audience was like, we should get involved with this.
Oh yeah.
And still getting a picture taken.
we're gonna get interviews with the Congeniality winners and the winner himself, Michael Dunn, once they're done taking pictures.
A little fact from Mr. Weibo for you. A junior has never won Mr. Weibo before in the 13 years, I want to say, it has been. 13 annual. And junior has never won.
Let's get a special thanks.
Yeah, you got a special thanks out to Mr. Foxworthy.
Our teacher.
Rick Davis.
And then Trevin Popwell, as right here.
And our custodial staff, along with Matt Mitchell, too.
Oh, okay. Hey. Sponsors are for the 2017 Constellation staff. Be Lindsay Kaufman, Becky Collins, Katie Collins, Elena Dickery, Shelby Dorwart, Lucy Evans, Haley Fields.
Molly Gorley, Lizzie Hendricks, Molly Kinsey, Hannah Lern, Riley Ramsey, Emily Voiles, Kella Wilkinson, Maddie Williams, and Whitney Weber. Those are all from the yearbook staff, and they just do a great job. And I can't wait to get my yearbook because there was a pretty big crowd tonight.
And hey, you know what? Hopefully I'll be in it.
Hopefully you'll be in it?
Yeah, hopefully I will. I was in last year's. Again, like we said, a good thanks to our contestants. Reese Thompson did a nice magic show. I thought he did a pretty well good job playing tic-tac-toe with the judges. And as you can see, they're separating right now.
Baron Martin's dad jokes weren't bad. You know, some people didn't get the paper one. I'm terrible. Still surprised they didn't get it. I mean,
yeah, it caught me off guard at first, but I caught it.
Zach Neff's painting.
Oh yeah, he did a really great job on that. It was so like it was honestly a really like I could hang that in my household.
Yeah.
I could. It was that good.
Duncan Reed dunking. Yeah. Kinda. Dunk and dunk.
Trampoline.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah.
Jumped over somebody. I thought it was Blake Griffin for a second.
On the car too. Uh-huh, he's in the car. Michael Dunn actually. Adam Meadows playing the guitar. I thought it was pretty good. He had the hair, the wig.
He said he even couldn't see when he was playing sometimes. That probably could have got him off note a little bit.
Michael Dunn, like we said, with the movie impressions, multiple movie impressions. Thought it was
pretty good. Those questions pretty well, too, it sounds like.
Oh, yeah. His Q&A was pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have Devin Vickery with the Mario theme song with the trumpet, which I thought was pretty cool.
I thought it was cool, but I don't think the older people, like the judges, I don't think they even understood it really well because I don't know if they even played Mario whenever they were younger. So
sometimes.
I think, you know, like that kind of got him off guard, but he's only a junior, so maybe next year he'll bounce back.
And then Zach Anderson with the 5,000 candles, he sang that very, very well.
Very beautifully.
He's going to IU, I believe.
He doesn't know what he wants to do yet, but he's a very intelligent man. He will surely be successful in his future.
And then a good friend of yours, Patrick Schallenberger.
Mm-hmm. There's so much to say about him. Hopefully he doesn't keep staying up like he has been lately when we have important things. But he did a great performance for only being able to play the guitar for a week and a half. He really did stand out, I thought. At first, though, I don't know if the mic was working or he's being a little quiet. Because I don't know if you heard it, but like you couldn't really hear him. I don't know if you could or not. But I thought that the mic wasn't right. But his swimsuit portion, he did pretty well. Mm-hmm. Not going to lie. Dalton Brown played the trumpet. You better Careless Whisper.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm not much of a music person, but I thought it was pretty good. No,
yeah, I mean, he said he missed some notes, but I can't tell. And, like, the only time I can really tell when people miss notes is if they tell me.
Oh, yeah.
Because I'm like, I thought it was beautiful. He said, oh, I missed a lot. I'm like, well, I think the crowd enjoyed it. And as long as you enjoyed it, I think you did a pretty good job.
Oh, yeah. And then you have John Miles Clutter with his impressions from Step Brothers. I thought it was pretty funny.
It was pretty funny. It took us a very, very long time. I had to help him the entire week just to get the song ready. He couldn't even hit the high notes. It took us around.
Well, he told us he edited the song so he could.
It took us around 3 days to edit that song to exactly where he wanted it. Back to Dalton Davis with auctioneering. We already talked about it, but it was just a great performance on his part.
I thought his swimsuit thing where he signed the beach ball and tossed it out. It was pretty good.
And last, and Felix, he just did, I mean, that was unbelievable, I think he made. You know, he's a mermaid, and it just, the fact that he made it himself was amazing. And we have our Mr. Weibo, Michael Dunn here with Colin Bruins and Jake McGee, and we'll send it over to them.
All right, thanks, guys. Like I said, I'm sitting here with Mr. Weibo 2017, Michael Dunn. Michael, congratulations, first of all. You worked really hard for this, I can tell you did. And there was a lot of good talent in this show, but what do you think made you stand out from the judges?
Well, for me, it was definitely a very, very tough field this year. A lot of contestants, a lot of good talents. But I guess what set me apart would be mine was just different. Something you don't see very often, so I think that would have scored good with the judges.
All right. And it must be those movies that really got them. I mean, you know, you had to act out a lot. Mm-hmm. Tell me about, like, the steps you took to make sure you acted each one of those scenes out accordingly so that it would seem as accurate as it could.
Well, lots of practice, obviously. I practiced this for my routine for quite a few weeks leading up to it. And I was able to get my steps down, kind of get a routine and get comfortable. And that's what you need to do, you know, just be comfortable out there. And I was able to do that.
Yeah, you talked about being comfortable. Were there any nerves at first when you started your act?
Yeah, because we had a little bit of trouble with the music at first. And, of course, the music is really everything for the talents. But we were able to figure it out, and everything turned out great.
Michael, can you explain the feeling that you had when they called out your name? For Mr. Weibo?
It was just total shock, honestly, because like I said, we had such a great group of guys out there and a lot of talented guys, and none of us really knew who was going to win. So it was total surprise.
Well, once again, there's a lot of talent, and you eventually came out on top. Congratulations. We're going to wrap up this interview here. Thank you all for joining us here at Western Boone for Mr. Weibo 2017. Michael, congratulations to you on winning Mr. Weibo. We're going to send it back to Matt and Trevin at the news desk to wrap it up.
Oh, that was a great night and great show. Unbelievable, the talent we had here. That'll be it for us. I'm Trevin Popwell.
I'm Matt Mitchell. And that'll be all for us here from this live broadcast of Mr. Weibo. Thank you for joining us.